How do I fill this thought building with life?
By visiting it regularly, which means concretely your soul goes to its homeland. The basic exercise is you visit the heaven which you have created in the subtle world in meditation in the morning, at noon, and in the evening. You put yourself in spirit in this wonderful room. At least your soul lives in paradise in these minutes, wherever your body is.
You fly in spirit to a mountain peak or to the ashram of your teacher in the Himalayas, as we have already described in detail in the broadcastings Exercise Elevation and Meditation. Let people travel in thought through the supermundane world. If their first attempts are primitive, they should not be discouraged. Help will come if the striving is sincere.
It is a miracle that such a sojourn in a higher world is possible regardless of the external circumstances. And yet, this is no imagination, but a real experience. Your transitory personality is tied to the material level. Your eternal individuality, on the other hand, can soar up to the spiritual spheres at any time. There, it finds the peace and quietness which it looks for in vain on earth.
And this miracle happens effortless, like a gift that falls from heaven.
No, unfortunately, it is not quite that simple. Nothing is given to us as a present, and certainly not paradise. It is a spiritual exercise, and not an easy one, to release your thoughts and feelings from the business, needs, suffering, and disgust of the material world. To keep your consciousness in the soul, in a sphere where you are not affected by all of this. You have to learn spiritual discipline. Again and again, your thoughts are straying away. As soon as they return to your earthly affairs, you immediately fall out of your heaven again. You have to get used to visiting your sanctuary for a few minutes in the morning, at noon, and in the evening. For this, you have to reserve fixed times and defend them against the demands of your environment. This must not remain a mere abstract idea.
The greatest happiness, dwelling in paradise, becomes a living experience.
The actual existence of your eternal individuality in this higher world becomes the stable center, the focus of your life.
The disciples asked, "Where will we be after death?" The thinker, Plato, answered, "Not far from here, and each of you can succeed already during his life to visit the place of his future abode."
After completing the meditation, you find yourself back again in your room. What do you experience? What do you feel?
In the beginning, there is no difference. It is as if I were still dwelling in my home, in the sanctuary, in the subtle world.
Exactly. That is the crucial experience. We had said at the beginning of this broadcasting.
You are living in heaven when you feel like being in heaven.
This is exactly what you now actually make come true. You feel like in heaven, and thus you live in paradise, even though physically you did not leave your apartment at all. It is of the utmost importance for your spiritual path that you establish this sublime state of consciousness in you at every morning, that you enjoy the beauty of a life in a higher sphere before you go out into the world. Only then will rise within you the longing never to give up this condition and to transform also your life on earth into a paradise. Let us extend the exercise. In worry, distress, or temptation, you can escape the world at any time. Go through a short emergency meditation and put yourself in your heaven, where you are protected and unassailable. Thus, in any situation, you will be quickly able to find peace of mind, tranquility, equanimity, balance, and joy of being. However, using this panacea at any time is no trifle, but a spiritual achievement, which requires a lot of effort and practice. In some parts of Asia, it is customary to retreat to a monastery for a few days before making an important decision. In a crisis, or in general, regularly, several times a year, for the purpose of collecting and purifying oneself in the order of a life in accordance with the cosmic laws. On the path of the interior temple, you can cultivate this wholesome practice without leaving your home. You may visit this virtual monastery temporarily whenever you want, several times a week, or even several times a day. We continue. We can do more than visiting the sanctuary in the morning, at noon, and in the evening. We can take it with us anywhere we want. Among the most beautiful and the most important that has ever been said on our topic is:
practice meditation and you will find that you are carrying within your heart a portable paradise. How can I make this happen?
One of the most notable pieces of advice from Agni Yoga is:
establish the temple within your heart. What do you mean by that?
We had already learned and practiced in the broadcasting living in the continuous presence of the teacher. Like a beloved one, you can also take your teacher into your heart and keep him there. Let us now expand this exercise. Always carry the image of your abode in the hereafter, of your eternal home from which you come and to which you will soon go back in your heart. You do love this place. You long to return there. Only there can you be happy.
The heart is a temple. When we talk about building a temple in the form of a heart, we do not have in mind a heart-shaped building. We are indicating the temple's inner significance. One should understand the temple of the heart as an urgent sensation. Let us start feeling ourselves to be bearers of this temple.
The establishment of the temple in the heart is the necessary consequence of a universal realization. We cannot achieve true peace of mind, tranquility, and calmness on the material level in a safe, permanent, and unassailable way. This is possible within ourselves only.
Happiness is not in a place. You can only find it within yourself. Few realize that only the heart is the abode of harmony.
That is why popular wisdom states so truly and beautifully,
"If you do not carry heaven in your heart, you will not be able to find it anywhere else."
Jesus, as well, recommended to look for paradise within ourselves.
The kingdom of God cometh not with outward gestures. Neither shall they say, "Lo, here," or "Lo, there." For, behold, the kingdom of God is within you.
Agni Yoga teaches the same lesson.
The fiery world is primarily within us, if only we discern its abode.
Everyone can move into this inner cell, whatever his material life may look like, while at the same time fulfilling all his earthly obligations and overcoming all hardship. Even those who have been thrown into prison or sold into slavery can free themselves from one moment to the other by soaring up to paradise and following this inner path.
A very old story tells how a certain king, desiring to free himself of all outside influences, asked a sage for advice. "In your heart you will find liberation," said the sage.
Live in this inner sanctuary all day. Carry the temple in your heart, wherever you go, whatever you do, and whatever happens to you. Even in the middle of the worldly turmoil, preserve the pure atmosphere of a sanctuary within you.
You build the temple in your heart and take it with you into the world. The stronghold of the yogi is in the heart.